Isn't it wonderful that worshiping Jesus never gets boring? There is no boredom in heaven. The angels are astonished right now at the beautiful face of Jesus. Over and over and over again, they're overwhelmed by how good he gets and how much gooder he keeps getting.
Oh my.
some fears that you won't turn into faith. If you got some water you won't turn into wine. If you got some blind eyes that you won't open wide. Let's lift it up to the Lord. Lord, turn my fears into faith. Fear, you cannot take my song away. Fear, you cannot take my song away. Yeah. You turn my fears into faith. See, you turn my fears into faith. You turn my fears into faith. Oh, you turn it all around. You turn my fears into faith. Faith, 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 faith. You turn my fears into faith. Oh, you turn my fears into faith. That's what you do. You turn my fears into faith. You turn my fears into faith. Oh, you turn my fears into faith. You turn my fears into faith. You turn my fears into faith. Oh, you turn my fears into faith.
Yeah. poison's in my veins. Resurrection's in my veins. I won't be afraid. Sometimes you just gotta say it. I won't be afraid. I won't be afraid. I won't be afraid. Courage and faith is waking up. I won't be afraid. Oh, I won't be afraid. I'm taking back my song. Fear you've had it for way too long. I'm taking back my soul. It's fear you've had it for way too long. Just say that. I'm taking back my soul. It's fear you've had it for way too long. Sing. I'm taking back my soul. It's fear you've had it for way too long. Taking back my soul. It's fear you've had it.
The first night we were in California, Monday night, I had a dream that I went into this room to put in my contacts, and I went to put it in my eye and it was too big. And I was like, why is this contact so big? It wouldn't fit. And I was like, weird. Put it back in the water, it would shrink back to size, and I'd put my finger and go to put it in my eye, it was huge. I was like, so weird. And I opened up the other one, tried to put it in, it was too big. And they were like shrinking. They were like getting bigger, smaller, bigger, smaller. It's so bizarre. I have to put in my contacts. I have to see. And I'm like, I'll just open a new pack. And I went to open a new pack and they were all dried up and shriveled. And I was like, Lord, what is going on? In the dream, I literally said that. And then I woke up and I felt like the Father said that this 2-week school is not about another lens. I believe with my whole heart that even the vision of the school is not to just give you another lens, but it's actually to heal your eyes. And that's the resurrection that's coming up out of you. It's to convince you of the mighty beauty of Jesus. And you don't need a lens, you actually need to just wake up. And that the whole point, the churning of all of this is that the true you would wake up, yeah? And that the Holy Spirit inside of you would wake up. And so the Holy Spirit inside of all of us is calling to the Jesus in you, is calling to the Spirit in you. So I think some of you are like, no, I just want a lens. Trust me, you don't want a lens. You wanna see, okay? You wanna see, so that when you go home to your churches and other countries and wherever you are, and the lens maybe not work the way you thought it was gonna. Yeah. It doesn't matter. Because you're alive. Do you understand? So Father, we receive the healing of our eyes, God. We wanna see the way you see, Father. And I declare an open heaven over your hearts right now that the Father's, he's aligning your heart. And he is turning your fear into faith. Yeah. And he's giving you the strength and the courage to reach out beyond what you thought you could. Father, we want to see the way you see. We want to sing what you're singing. We want to hear what you're saying. We want to move like you're moving, God. We want to see colors the way you see them, Father. Heal our eyes, God. 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 No more lenses, no more filters. We wanna see you just as you are. Heal our eyes, God. Let's put our hand on our heart. Heal our eyes, God. Heal our eyes, God. Heal our eyes, God. We want to see you as you are. We want to see you as you are. Heal our eyes, God. Heal our eyes, God. Heal our eyes, God. No more lenses, no more filters. We want to see you as you are. I want to see you as you are. I want to see you as you are. I want to see you as you are. Oh, heal our eyes, God. Oh, heal my eyes, God. Heal my eyes. Heal my eyes, God. I want to see you as you are. Oh, heal my eyes, God. Heal my eyes, God. Oh, heal my eyes. Heal my eyes. Oh, heal my eyes. We want to see you as you are, faithful and true, mighty to save.
These prison thoughts
wings be broken and the winter be done. Will you come out of your hiding? Kiss me, sweet warm sun. Let the wind of your spirit blow the dust off.
He promised is what he
all the disappointment fades, and all the heaviness fades, and all the seasons fade. Faithful and true, mighty to save, you are good, good God. Faithful and true, mighty to save, you're a good, good God. Let's just sing that to the Lord. Faithful and true, mighty to save, you're a good, good God. Faithful and true, mighty to save, you're a good, good God. Ah, that's right. Faithful and true, mighty to save, you're a good, good God. All the fear and doubt fades. Faithful and true, mighty to save, you're a good, good God. Faithful and true, mighty to save, you're a good, good God. Let's stand up real straight and tall. The Lord loves confidence. I'm so sick of false humility. That is not Jesus. Jesus Christ, who created the heaven and earth, died on a cross, rose again, is inside of you. Therefore, you do not have to walk around like this. Yeah, I mean, I maybe sing a little. And yeah, I mean, only by the grace of God do I have anything. No, you stand up straight and tall, because confidence rooted in humility honors the Father. Confidence rooted in humility honors the Father. And you know what else it honors? It honors the cross. Jesus did not scurry out of hell with the keys to death and like, oh, I'm gonna sneak out. No, he boldly took them, said, peace, I'm out. Do you understand? There's a posture shift in your heart that has to happen. Confidence is rooted in humility. It is not arrogance, because it's rooted in your total dependence on Jesus. Guys, the Holy Spirit is in you. That is profound. It should change your life every day. He sent a helper to help you stand straight and tall in confidence, yeah? So let's declare who the Lord is. It's good for you. We sing it over and over because we're teaching our soul and our heart to believe it, yeah? We don't sing it over and over because God forgot. And he's like, oh yeah, I need to be faithful today.
Thank you.
I want to walk off my map, Lord. I want to walk off what I know into the love that surpasses everything I could ever know. I want to walk out of this little boat of religion onto the water. This Wednesday morning, I take a step closer. Hey guys, you're not as free as you're gonna be. You're not as free as you're gonna be. There's more freedom every morning. There's more freedom every moment. Let's take a step a little bit closer.
Is reduced to a love song. It's a really good thing. Father's calls in some of you to remember your first love. Good things have forgot you, have caused you to forget it. And he's bringing us back to the love song we were born to sing. I can hear those love songs that me and my wife fell in love with. 14 some years ago. And as soon as I hear him, I'm taken back to that first love moment. I see for some of you guys, the Father's hitting play on the original love song he sang over you. And you all of a sudden, you're just head over heels again with Jesus. If you can't write a love song, maybe you can't write a worship song, because that's all it is. So yeah, if you just want to remember that love song, let's just raise our hands. Jesus, we want to be head over heels again. Just completely swept away. Restore first love in this school. Bring us all the way back to our first love. And that we would fall into it the rest of our days. Amen.
That's amazing. Thank you, guys. I just... Wasn't that good? I just tweeted that line you just said. That was amazing. If you can't write a love song, you can't write a worship song, because that's all it is. I mean, I think that kind of sums up the whole thing, doesn't it? Why don't we do this? Just lay your hands on someone next to you. Let's pray into this for each other this morning. It's just so amazing just to sit and worship with a couple who has spent their lives going after God. And it's very apparent and obvious to me, you know, the anointing and just the authority. And that whole thing, Lord, about the love of God and coming back to our first loves. And so just start to pray for one another for that. Lord, we asked even more, Lord. Jesus, remind us what it is. Remind us of those things, Lord, even in our own hearts that maybe we've lost, that we've gone astray from, that we've gone after a good thing, but maybe it's not you. And I pray, Lord, that you would reset some things in us, reset some things in me, in my own heart, with my time, with my schedule, with my emotions, with my passions, Lord, that they would all line up to one thing, and that's loving you, that everything I do in life would be pointing and pushing into loving you more, Lord. Pray for everyone in this room right now, throughout this school. That would be the main focus, the main thing, the main heart cry. Our heart would beat for that, Lord. Whether we're learning guitar or learning how to sing, that would be our heart cry, loving you, Lord. Expand our revelation about what that is. That word's used so much in our culture, in this in worship. It's like, we love you, Lord. What does that mean? Teach us what that means, Lord, on an individual basis for every person in this room. What does it mean to love you more? What does it mean to give you more of ourselves? Amen.